Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are discussing about Java environment. Okay, so here what exactly Java contains and how we need to write a simple Java program, and I will explain each and every line code with Java. Now introduction about Java environment, tools of Java development kit, application programming interface and simple Java program. Now it is a product from Sun Microsystem, which is a collection of n number of tools and utilities which are used together to develop dynamic applications using Java. The development tools are part of the system known as Java Development Kit, and the classes and methods are part of the Java standard library known as Application Programming Interface. Now we are learning about Java Development Kit, what it contains, and Application Programming Interface, what it contains. Now, tools of Java Development Kit. First one is Java C. It is a compiler. Java compiler converts source code into byte code. So how we are performing it means Java C, file name dot Java. It stands for Java compiler, which takes the source code and translates into byte code. Next one is Java. It is Java interpreter to convert source code into byte code into machine code and execute the program. So how we need to do? Java file name. It stands for Java interpreter that interrupts the byte code and produces the output. Next one is applet viewer for viewing applet Java applets. So applet viewer file name dot Java. It is used to run applet based programs that provides graphical interface. Now Java P, Java help. It stands for Java deassembler, which will explore all methods and properties of the given class. Java P, full qualified class name. JDB, Java debugger. It stands for Java debugger. It makes the class file to execute line by line interruption. JDB, class name, class file. JavaDoc, Java documentation. It is used to create HTML files for every class and method used in the program. JavaDoc, file name dot Java. So now we are moving into application programming interface. Java standard library includes hundreds of classes and methods grouped into several functional packages. Most commonly used packages are, now we need to know what is a package. Package is nothing but collection of classes and interfaces. It is a collection of classes and interfaces. So here I am explaining few classes which are available in Java. Not all, only few are discussed. First one is language support packages, a collection of classes and methods required for implementing basic features of Java. Utilities package, a collection of classes to provide utility functions such as date and time functions. Input output packages, a collection of classes required for input output manipulations. Networking packages, a collection of classes for communicating with other computer via network. AWT package, the abstract window toolkit package, contains classes that implements platform independent graphical user interface. AWT means abstract window toolkit. Applet package, this includes a set of classes that allows us to create Java applet. Now I will explain a simple program. These are the line numbers followed by the respective code. The first line contains class is a keyword and example is an identifier. Class is a keyword and example is an identifier. These are the separators. Public is a keyword, static is a keyword, void is a keyword, main is the identifier, and string is the data type, and aux is then an identifier. System is a keyword. System is a class, out is an object, println is the method to display the message. Now I am specifying that I rounded is called keywords. Non-rounded are some of them are special meaning. So the keyword class means that what we are writing next is called the class. And example is an identifier indicates that name of the class. Public means it is in the main method will call publicly so that we are defining the class public. Static means without creating an object, the class will be invoked with the help of the keyword static. Without creating an object, the class will be invoked, class will be executed with the help of the keyword static. Void means returns nothing. It is one of the data type, returns nothing. Main method, symbolically we are using, main is the method to starting. So here also we indicating the main. In Java, we can create n number of mains, but which method having static keyword will be executed first. So arguments, array of arguments of type string. System is a class. Out is an object. Println is the method to display the message. So this is the way we are writing the sample programs. So we need to save this file as example data. This example is nothing but name of the class. Now I am in detail I also wrote, so I will just read it. Class example, it defines a class named example using a keyword class. After that, class definition is specified within curly braces. Line 3, public static void main string args. This is the point from where the program will start the execution. The public keyword is used to control the access of various class members. If member is public, it can be accessed outside the class. So we have to declare main as public because it has to be invoked by the code outside the class when program is executed. Static keyword allows the main method to be executed without creating an object of that class. And void means main method does not return any value. String args. String is a predefined class and it takes any type of variable. This represents free array. Array args represents reference variable of string type. And line 5 contains system.out.println. Welcome to Java. System is the class from java.long package that contains all input output related reference variables. Out is a variable of system class. Println function is used to display this line. So how we need to run the program? Whenever we are running a program, first we need to set the path. Next is compile the program, followed by run the program. Already we discussed about compilation, Java C, program name dot Java, Java interpreter, Java program name. How we are saving, we get the path, path will be set. In the next video, we will explain how to set a path and how we need to run a sample Java program. Thank you.